Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to episode 88 or 89, could be 90, of the Spearhead Sundays podcast. Spearhead Sundays? Why, more like Spearhead Sundays? Nah, more like Spearhead Monday. Alright, yeah, fuck you, alright? You're right. This is the one time where you're right. I fucked up this week. I do apologize. But, you know, keep your comments to yourselves, you dirty cunts. It's still free, alright? It's still fucking free. When it's coming out on a paid service, hit me up. Hit me up with your complaints. Until then, I don't know. This is basically charity, all right? I've started a fucking charity organization to help cure you of your incredible boredom ailment. And for some reason, it's... Dude, it's like... You know what it's like? Okay? I'm like World Vision. And I demand to be treated with the same amount of respect that World Vision receives. Because, you know, when the fucking Make-A-Wish Foundation is hooking up that 8-year-old who's going to die of AIDS in 2 weeks, you know, when he gets to meet fucking, I don't know, The Rock or some shit, all right? That kid isn't going to be... If The Rock is 2 days late and the kid dies, I mean, well, actually, that's a really bad analogy because you definitely would complain. Like, that's the mother of late deliveries, isn't it? that's the fucking... Dude, sometimes I get post... That's late. Like, I'm waiting for samples of my t-shirt for the comedy special to arrive, and it's like 2 days late, and that's a little bit annoying. But man, if I was the father of an 8-year-old who was dying of AIDS, and The Rock was 2 days late, and he died like on one day, you know, 1 day late, that's when he died, I would be so fucking angry. Like, that's more than an inconvenience. You know what I mean? Like, that's a big deal. Anyway, despite my bad analogies, what I'm trying to say, ladies and gentlemen, is it'll never happen again. That's a big call. It probably isn't going to happen again for a long time because I've figured out my schedule. I'm recording this after Luke and I have done our radio show. I'm actually sitting here inside the 2-day FM Hit 104.1 professional radio studios. Like, I'm sitting here looking at literally about $1 million worth of recording equipment, mixing desk, lights, branding, a desk that goes up to the roof, and I'm recording this podcast on my fucking iPhone. Like, that's the amount of disrespect I'm showing to this multi-million-dollar operation. I see all this stuff, I'm like, yeah, I could learn how to use it. Someone has offered to teach me, hey man, would you like to record Spearhead Sundays on the good microphones? And I'm like, no. I'm not going to do that. But yeah, so life is going pretty well. Luke and I just finished our first month of radio, and I'm not going to talk about too much about radio because, you know, again, it's fucking, you hear about that every day on the Luke and Lewis show. But the main update is I didn't tell you about this because we weren't sure if we were going to be extended or not, but we were given initially 1 month of radio. They said, you can be on radio until the end of October, and if we like you, we might keep you on. And we've got to the end of October, we had our big race, we had a whole bunch of people show up in real life to an event, and they were really impressed with that, and our show has been extended to the end of the year, which is really fucking incredible. So I'm grateful that you guys like it, and I hope that you guys continue to listen to it, because I think that me and Luke have really kind of struck something good with this thing. And you know what else is good about this is Luke's podcast was also late, and he's actually recording his podcast at the exact same time in the studio next to me, and we're surrounded by a glass wall, and I'm just waving at him. I'm being a distraction right now, and we're making eye contact, but we can't hear each other because it's incredibly soundproof. I imagine in his podcast that he uploads tomorrow, it'll be a massive distraction. In fact, you know what? I'm just going to go and say hello to him just to prove that I'm not fucking around, because so I'm just coming into the public work area now. I'm just going to make a guest appearance on Luke's podcast. And here we go. We are now in. We just made it into. Just made it into Luke's podcast, dude, ladies and gentlemen.
This sucks. I just.
All right, that's it. That's all I wanted to do. I just wanted to prove that we weren't lying. All right, bye.
Bye.
Hey, what are you about to talk about?
New Zealand.
Mm.
I missed last week.
Enjoy it, everyone.
Yeah, so that'll be...
Okay, so I'm coming back into my studio now, and you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to lower the blinds, because you know that I am such a fucking weirdo that I can't pay attention to anything without... So, can you hear that? That's the sound of blinds being lowered. And they're being lowered electronically. Sorry, I'm just lowering myself to the floor as the blinds go down to distract Luke further. Anyway, so as I was saying, yeah, these are like robo blinds, man. It's fucking crazy. Like this studio is so expensive and such a waste of money. Like they like instead of getting some fucking blinds that were just blinds. You know what I mean? They couldn't get just blinds. Like, someone was like, oh, man, we really need blinds here. And then instead of... like, someone's like, hey, you know what would be good to separate the studios to stop radio shows from distracting each other? How about some blinds? And then all the other guy heard was, oh, you mean, like, blinds from IKEA? And the other guy's, yeah, we could get some from IKEA that work the same as these ones. Or we could get custom-made blinds with branding on them that are lowered electronically with a button that is hooked up to the wall. Also, the blinds are custom cut to fit our studio specifically, and they all lower at the same time. And someone was like, dude, these blinds, honestly, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, there's 7 of these robo blinds. That's got to cost at least fucking 10 grand. I bet they spent $10,000 on blinds. And that really goes to show you how much money is in this shit. It's just, I can't shit on it too much because, you know, I fucking work here. But it's just insane. Dude, they spent more on blinds than they're paying us for a month of radio. Dude, they're like, oh, we can't pay you very much money because there's no ads on Triple M Modern Digital. It's like, yeah, but there's no ads on your fucking blinds and you spent 10 grand on those. At least, you know, pay me a little bit above minimum wage. I mean, fuck, I'm working way harder than these blinds. These blinds don't even lower, they're like, oh, well, I suppose they lower themselves. That's a little bit of work. But you know what I mean, guys? Starving to death here. Trying to move out of my fucking parents' house before I hit 30. All right, what did I want to talk about? Okay, so... belt update. Belt update alert. So, as you heard in last week's podcast, or maybe the week before that, I was having belt problems. I tried to buy myself a nice fucking belt to congratulate myself on getting a radio show. And so I bought the belt, right? Quick little recap. I bought myself a nice belt. I really liked the belt. I bought it. It wasn't like an insane $1 million belt, but it was a nice, it was like my first nice belt. I'm like, you know what? I want a nice belt today. I feel like I fucking earned a good belt. So I buy a nice belt online. It arrived, and even though I did this, even though I got a fucking tape measure out and measured my waist, measured my belt, and then applied it to their sizing chart, it comes, and of course, it just doesn't fucking fit me. So then I had to be like, all right, well, what am I going to do with this belt? I need to try and return it. So I took it to a store, and they were like, hey, yeah, we don't have the belt to swap you with, and we can't give you a refund. We can only give you store credit for the store that doesn't have the belt. So anyway, last we heard, I sent it off. I posted it off to the online store, and I asked for one in my size. And they get back to me, and they go, hey, we don't have the one in your size, so we're giving you a refund. So I get all my money back. And then fucking the next day, oh, the belt comes back online and you can buy it. And it's not a pre-order, right? It's not coming soon. It's not a pre-order. It's not, we'll let you know when it's back in stock. It's fucking there and I paid for it and they have my money. And then it said order confirmed, right? So I'm like, sweet, can't wait to get my fucking belt. Paid for express shipping, ladies and gentlemen. That's how excited I was to wear my fucking belt that I've paid money for. And then, right, about a week after that, I hit them up and I go, hey, paid for express shipping, man. It's one of the rare times in my life when I've ever wanted express shipping. I want my damn belt. And then they get back to me and they go, hey, man, so yeah, we have your money. So that was basically instantaneous. So there's nothing wrong on your end. But just wanted to let you know that the belt that you bought was so popular with other people that we might not be able to ship it for a while. And I was like, cool, so you sold me something that you don't fucking have. And so I get back to them, and I'm like, all right, yeah, sweet. That's fine. When the fuck are you going to send me the belt? Like, obviously, now you have to make the belt, right? Because it's just this fucking belt mystery. It needs to be unraveled. I'm like, do you have a belt sitting in a warehouse that is going to be sent to you and then sent to me? Or is the belt being made by some 8-year-old Bangladeshi kid getting whipped to death next to his sister? All right? Tell me where the fuck my belt is. And then they go, all right, we need to make your belt. We need to manufacture your belt from scratch. I'm like, sweet. I now made that, fucking Bangladeshi thought his job was done when they ran out of belts. And they're like, oh, finally, I'm sick of making this damn belt. And then they get another order from me. And they go, ah, too late, buddy. Some 23-year-old from Australia wants you to make him a belt. So there's no sleep and no school until it's fucking done. So anyway, I'm like, well, when am I going to get my fucking belt? And they get back to me, and they go, yeah, so here's the deal. Because we have to manufacture the belt, and it's very popular worldwide, they hit me with that as well. So I know that it's going to be on the furthest end of their fucking estimate. They were like, no shit, in the fucking email it says, I'm going to get the email up for you right now, all right? Where's this fucking email? I'm so angry about this shit. Hang on. Belt. Oh, I have like 15 fucking email accounts now. Right, like contact at Lou Spears and podcasts, and then we got a Luke and Lewis one, and now I have a fucking tickets one. Belt company. Where is this fucking belt brand? Oh yeah, shipment update. Dear Lewis, we thank you for shopping with Belt Company, blah, blah, blah. We would like to share with you a brief update on the status of your online order. Dude, how funny is the language difference when you buy something nice? Like, when you buy something from fucking, I don't know, ASOS, they go, hey, hashtag, hello, relatable email, we would like to emoji this to you, and your refund number is this, post a selfie on Instagram, hashtag, relate, like, it's just a 30-year-old pretending to be a fucking 18-year-old, but then when you buy something from, like, a nice clothing store, like, not fucking super luxury, but nicer than regular clothes, they pretend like you're not just some fuckhead buying a belt, and they pretend like this email account amounts to the kind of personalized service they give at their shitty fucking flagship stores. You know that shit? So this is their wanky email they sent me. Look, all they needed to say was, hey, Lewis, your order's confirmed. It's shipping here. But they sent me 6 paragraphs, so I'm not even going to read half of this shit. Dear Lewis, we thank you again for shopping with us at Belt Company. I'm not saying the brand. We would like to share with you a brief update on the status of your online order. At this time, the belt that you ordered is a very high demand. Let's get to the fucking point. Where are we? I don't, honestly didn't think I'd get this mad about a fucking belt, but here we are, ladies and gentlemen. At this time, the belt you ordered is at a very high demand worldwide, and as such, we have not received as many shipments as we hoped / expected. Well, which one is it? Did you hope you were going to get some, or did you expect? Because one thing is running a business effectively, and the other one is just crossing your fingers and your toes and hoping that shit works out. You can't just fucking hope. I hope that I'm going to sell all the tickets to my comedy special, but you fucking know I'm going to post about it. Okay, the belt. I'm going to pass out. As such, we have not received as many shipments as we hoped or expected. While we always strive to deliver your order as promised, we are regrettably unable to meet the delivery quoted to you at the time of your order. So basically, that was 3 sentences that said, hey, I know that we took your money and we told you that it was in stock, but it wasn't because we crossed our fingers instead of doing some actual fucking work. We have taken the opportunity to place you on the wait list for this item. Cool! You've got my money. You're like, I'll put him on a wait list. We don't want to fucking refund the cunt. And here's the expected date range, ladies and gentlemen. This is how fucking big, this is no shit what they told me. At this stage, All right. You would think, okay, let me just, before we brace this, when I started reading this email, I was like, okay, cool. They're going to tell me when it's going to come. Even if it's going to take a long time, surely they'll be able to tell me like within a 2 week date range, right? 2 weeks, that's a long date range. Listen to this. At this stage, your order is now expected to ship between the 1st of December, 2017. So that is, well, it's 2 days from now, all right? So the 1st of December, 2017, or the 31st of February 2018. That is next year. I want my fucking belt today. Please note that all items are subject to availability and we will be sure to update you in the rare case that we cannot fulfill your order. Rare case? What are you saying? I ordered it. It came in the wrong size. I went to the store. They didn't have it. And then I refunded it, sent it in online, paid for it again, and you still didn't have it. You have not have it more times than I've bought it. That's super fucking common. Rest assured. You may, of course, modify or cancel your order at any time. Jesus Christ. So, yeah, that's an update on my belt, ladies and gentlemen. How far are we into this thing? I'm actually, my ears hurt at how loud I was fucking yelling about that shit. I need to get my asthma inhaler. It's 16 minutes, but fuck, I don't want to stop the podcast because it's so big here, this studio, man. Like, it's fucking huge. Because a lot of people don't know this, but Triple M and Fox, or the Hit Network, or whatever the fuck they want to call themselves, they're owned by the same company, so they're in the same building. So a lot of people are like, oh, Triple M? Oh, they're going under. And it's like, dude, no, they're not. Triple M is just has a different fucking market. I don't know why people think Triple M is going under. Like, they have gambling ads, bro. I would wager that they might even be making more than... I don't fucking know. What am I in the Illuminati? Oh, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to pretend that I'm on the phone while I walk up to my office. How sick is that? I got my office, ladies and gentlemen. All right, so I'm leaving the studio now. Just walking down. I'm just going to give the finger to Luke. Just as I walk past, that really distracted him. And so I'm just... What I've done, because I've recording this on my phone, right? I've just put the phone to my ear. And I'm pretending that I'm on a phone call to someone, which, you know, basically I am. I mean, it's just a very delayed phone call, really, isn't it? So, now I'm in Triple M. You're about to hear a bunch of rock music and man ads. Can you hear that? This is Triple M. All right. They're advertising insurance. So, we're at the Triple M. I'm about to go up the stairs and we're going to get to Fox. And it's going to start advertising stuff like, I don't know, tampons and flowers. All right, so we're going upstairs here. All right, now we're in the Hit and the Fox thing. There's a giant wall-sized mural of Justin Bieber, and he signed it too. Oh, I really want to cross it out, but that'll get me fired. And you know what? Fair enough. All right, so I'm about to walk past the janitor, the cleaner. Hey, see, look at me being nice to co-workers and everything. Well, look, he cleans up after me. I make a lot of mess. All right, just made it to my office. Now I need to find my inhaler. Do you understand how much of a fucking dick? You guys thought, oh, is he going to change when he gets into radio? It's like, no. I'm still going to be swearing my head off about fucking belts and taking, looking for my puffer. The only difference is looking for the puffer is going to take 10 more minutes because the building I'm in is fucking huge. All right, ready to go. Now I'm going to need to go back downstairs. So we're still in Fox. They've put Halloween stuff everywhere in the office. It's pretty cool, man. Anyway, so run out of things to say now that I can breathe properly and I'm not angry about this fucking belt. Oh, there's Justin Bieber again on the way down. Oh, that's not my. Sorry, I just saw someone's wallet there. I was like, is that my wallet? Of course, it's not your wallet, idiot. You don't sit in that chair. All right, so we're going back down the stairs, and we're about to enter Triple M, so it's about to get a whole lot more masculine. Yeah, the boys fucking sport. Who's talking? I don't know who's on radio right now. All right, so now we're going back into the studios. Oh, I'm really regretting doing this. I definitely should have paused. How fucking boring is this? Anyway, walking down the hallway. That's right, we're almost at Luke again. I'll give him the finger as well. As we're going through. Alright, so. Walking back, and I'm currently giving him the finger. He looks really distracted. And heading back into my own studio. And as soon as I shut the door, it'll be soundproof, so I can say... Cunt! Alright, what else do I want to talk about today, ladies and gentlemen? Where are we? Where are my fucking notes that I've left here? Oh, that's right. Dude, you know what I saw the other day that grossed me out? So I was, I had a meeting with the New Zealand tour manager, just to recap everything and make sure we're all on the same page. Boy, it's boring. It's not part of the fucking... what I'm talking about. Anyway, after the meeting, he's like, hey, do you want to get some food? I was like, yeah, sweet, let's get some food. And he goes, he no shit says to me, oh, cool, I know a really good burrito joint that's at a petrol station. Which is like, oh, I know a really good hooker in a meth house. It's like, do you really know a hooker, or did you have sex once and you haven't, you know, got the STDs checked yet? Because... I'm pretty fucking sure that burritos and servo don't go together, right? But anyway, he took us there. I fought him on it, but he swore by it. So I'm like, all right, I'll trust you. I'll at least look at this place. And I go there, and it's really nice, right? So it's like this new fucking thing that they're trying out. I don't know what it is, man. It's all these different businesses are trying to... out fancy themselves, like it's stay in your lane. Do you know what I mean? Like, you're a service station, just be a fucking service station. You don't need to pretend to be a fancy service station. Like, dude, not once. Here's something that that no human has ever said. Oh, gee, while I fill up my car with unleaded 98, you know what I could go for? What? A fucking beef burrito. That'd be sick. Like, no one's ever said that. No one's ever thought that. It's unnecessary. But then again, you know what, ladies and gentlemen? That's what human ingenuity is. It's just figuring out how to create demand in a market where there is none. Like, unnecessary demand is such a fucking thing now. No one ever wanted or thought about having a burrito while they filled up their petrol, but one cunt decided, hey, if I market it properly, it'll fucking work, and it has. So we go to this survey station. Dude, we didn't even get petrol. We just went there only for burritos. You kidding me, man? Like, that's fucking effective. Now you got people rocking up to the servo station who can't even fucking drive. That's me. Anyway, so we go to this burrito joint. That's not even what the story is about. I keep getting sidetracked. So we go to this fucking burrito joint. I shouldn't have yelled for the first 15 minutes of this podcast about my belt. I should have saved that for the end when I had 2 minutes left. And I could have just been like, yeah, quick update. The belt hasn't come yet. Anyway, I feel like I need to fucking sit down and breathe. I got to do yoga, man. See, all of this shit with the radio and the comedy special and the New Zealand tour has just left me fucking highly strung. So this is where I come to yell in a sound. Like, I've literally just come down to a soundproof box so I can scream my head off about a fucking belt that doesn't matter. Anyway, so we go to this servo station. I get my burrito. We sit down, start eating it. Lovely. Brilliant. Feeling like an idiot for having doubted the servo burrito. But then, there's like a public toilet, right? But it's not like a nice... Like, there was a nice burrito place in the service station. There was not a nice public toilet. Okay? Just because there's a burrito joint at the servo station doesn't automatically transform their public bathroom into, I don't know, where would be a nice public bathroom? Wherever the Pope shits, all right? The woods? Hey! Oh, you guys should stop listening right there. That'd be a perfect point to just stop. Because it's going to go... Well, actually, it probably isn't going to get any worse than that. It's only uphill from there. I just hit below rock bottom then. Anyway, so we're sitting, and there's like the door to the public toilet. And I went in there for a wee. And let me tell you, I was glad that I... I should have been dressed in a fucking hazmat suit. I was glad I didn't need to do a squat. Anyway, so I go in there for a wee, I come back out, and then I start eating my burrito. Did wash my hands, though. And we're sitting there eating for like 10 minutes, and then this guy walks past us, no shoes on, barefoot, not even socks. Like, he wasn't wearing... Dude, if he did this in thongs, I would have thought, that's fucking gross. But he did it barefoot, no socks, no foot protection. He walks past me towards the bathroom. And all of us see this guy in no shoes. This is like 9 p.m. at night, by the way, ladies and gentlemen. So you know it hasn't been cleaned for like 12 hours. We see this cunt start to walk past us and go to the bathroom. And we see him going to the bathroom. I'm like, no, he's not. There's no way he's going to do that. And then he gets close to the door. I'm like, no fucking way. And then he puts his hand on the door. And me and Matt are going, what the fuck, man? He's not going to do it. And then he pulls the door open. Steps in barefoot, no shoes, uncovered feet into a service station fucking bathroom where I had been in there before. And I can tell you, ladies and gentlemen, without a doubt in my mind that there was piss in between that cunt's toes from the moment he stepped foot in that filthy fucking bathroom. And he did it in bare feet. No shoes. In a public bathroom. That's the most fucked up thing that I've ever seen in my life. And I actually waited for him. I actually was in disbelief that we were going to wait for him to come out, because we were like, dude, there's no way the dude had bare feet. Like, surely he didn't. Maybe we were like, oh, that was just a trick of the light and that tricked all three of us. There's no way that actually happened. But anyway, I was waiting for him to come out so that I could film his feet walking out of it, like for Snapchat, so I could film the door open and then film his bare feet walking away and then point the camera at like the bathroom symbol, because that would have been a really funny Snapchat. But he didn't end up coming out for 20 minutes, and then we ended up leaving. We saw him come out of the bathroom while we were in the car, and he was indeed wearing bare feet. But, I mean, I don't know what he was doing in there for 20 minutes. Probably trying to cut his fucking toes off because I got gangrene. But that's the... I've seen some fucked up stuff, ladies and gentlemen. I mean, Pornhub exists, and that's the most fucked thing I've ever seen in my life. Actually, no. Take it back. Not the most fucked thing I've ever seen. Read about this. That blew my mind. Man, how do people not see Skynet coming? Like, how do they... Well, not even coming. Like, it's in progress. How the fuck do people not see that we are trusting robots and technology way too much? Like, already. It's already fucked. This thing made me go, yeah, we need to stop. Dude, do we really need more shit? Like, really honestly think about, I'm talking like where the best examples of it are, okay? So in Australia, our internet sucks. But in other places, it's as good as it needs to be, right? Surely. Like at the radio station here, I can upload an hour-long video to YouTube in 10 seconds. And that is not an exaggeration at all. I have my my download and upload speeds. It's on my phone, but I'm recording on my phone. So I can't read it out. But I'll tell you what. I'll post a screenshot of my download and upload speeds at the radio studio in the Speared Sundays podcast group right now. When the podcast is up. So you can go and check and you can see how fucking good the internet is here. I'll talk about it next week. It's not what I wanted to talk about. But what I'm saying is, like, where technology currently, wherever it is the best, it doesn't need to get any better than that, right? The internet, what we need to focus on right now is, instead of making shit better or supposedly better or adding features that we don't fucking need, like AI and robots doing our jobs, we don't need that shit. All we need is to figure out who's doing technology best and make that global. Because right now we're stuck in this fucking loop and it's all driven by money. Apple is at the head of it, where they make something a little bit better in a way that makes the old version obsolete, and then the whole world has to catch up, and that way some fucking poor kid in Africa is like, hey guys, I know the new iPhone is out, and that's really cool, but I don't have electricity! And I really need some fucking water that isn't gonna poison me. That'd be great. Can we work on that and then work on the next fucking iPhone? Can we get me up to at least Nokia stats? That's what I'm saying, ladies and gentlemen. We need to stop innovating technology in the first world and just work on making it global and then make it better gradually as we go, right? Because we don't need any of, like, all of the innovations I have heard about, apart from maybe virtual reality, I do think that's cool. That's the only thing that I've been like, oh yeah, cool, that's something that we will actually need at some point. That's kind of cool. But even then, it is unnecessary when you really think about it. But it's the only, like, new technology apart from electric cars that has been like, yes, that blows my mind, let's do that. But, like, okay, here's the example that I'm using. Amazon has come up with a new feature for their Amazon Prime subscribers, which already Amazon Prime is fucking bullshit. Right? Disclaimer, before I shit all over Amazon Prime, just know that I don't know what the fuck I'm talking about. Alright? So, with this Amazon Prime shit, basically how I understand it is you pay a little bit extra, you pay a monthly fee and you get priority shipping and access to cheaper products. Basically, you pay more money to spend more money in Amazon. I don't know. It's one of those things where it's like, oh, let's put a burrito joint in a service station. No one asked for it. Nobody needed it. If you told anyone the idea, everyone would say that sucks. But if you market it properly, some fucking idiot will pay for it. And this service that I looked up is exactly that, all right? So it's called Amazon Key. Already, I'm getting warning fucking signs of this shit, okay? So Amazon Key is basically for all Amazon Prime customers, so you're already paying them a monthly fee to get your fucking, I don't know, your condom shipped to you 20 minutes earlier than the rest of the population, because you're an idiot. What it is you have to pay for a $140 lock owned by Amazon, which means that it's connected to the internet, which means it can be hacked, just like your fucking iCloud, and then all of a sudden all those shots of your gooch get out to the fucking internet and it goes viral. And that, that poor woman who got her fucking life fucked up because everyone thought she was like a wholesome celebrity, and then because she was like quirky in interviews. And girls are like, oh my god, she's so quirky, like I just feel like I would be friends with her if I ever met her. And guys are like, oh my god, she's so wholesome, I feel like I could marry her. Like, everyone just assumed this bitch was a fucking saint because she was funny on Conan. What was her name? She's in that fucking bow and arrow movie. Jennifer Lawrence, that bitch, right? I feel sorry for her because as soon as everyone found out what her fucking asshole looked like, she just, it was like, oh, I don't want to see her movies. She's into sex. Yuck! It's like, dude, just because she was funny on Letterman once doesn't mean she, I don't know, she can't be a dirty bitch in her fucking private time. Like, leave her alone. Everyone's fucked up. Anyway, it's called Amazon Key. So basically, it's this fucking electronic door lock that connects to your phone so that whenever you get near your front door, it just unlocks automatically so you don't have to lock it. So yeah, that's never going to malfunction. That will never be hacked. That's always going to work. Fucking awesome. This is what I'm talking about. We don't need this shit, but some fucking retard's going to buy it and then he's going to get his front door hacked. Like, that shit happens. And basically the idea is, right, because you're an Amazon Prime customer, obviously you're ordering shit off Amazon all the time, you buy your $140 fucking doorknob, and then how it works is when you buy something from Amazon, the delivery driver can unlock your front fucking door, come into your house and put the package there, and then the idea is that he doesn't leave and he doesn't go through your underwear drawer and sniff your wife's fucking underwear, right? That's the idea. Like, that's never gonna happen. Yeah, sure. Why don't we trust 300,000 people working on fucking minimum wage not to break into rich people's houses? Because you know they're rich because they're spending like a week's pay on a fucking shiny doorknob that unlocks for you. Like, we needed that shit. And it's the dumbest... Well, it's the best idea for Amazon and the dumbest fucking idea for the population, because every cunt who buys one is going to be like, oh, well, I'm already giving $10 a month to Amazon Prime so I can get my fucking condom shipped 20 minutes earlier than the rest of the population, and I spent $150 on a fucking doorknob, so I better buy all of my groceries and all of my laptops from Amazon too. It's just like, oh, I spent $150 on a doorknob, and it's literally its only feature is I can shop with Amazon like I already was doing. I should buy more shit. And, like, we don't need that. Could you imagine walking... like, someone's going to build a fucking device that detects these doors and can unlock them. And they're just going to drive up and down fucking neighborhoods like they have a metal detector, except it's a fuckhead detector. Like, who's dumb enough to buy one of these doorknobs? And then they just unlock them, run into the house, take all of their shit, and then blame it on the Amazon delivery driver, and then he gets fired. Like, that's definitely going to happen. What do you really think, like, out of the thousands of fucking people working on minimum wage for Amazon, on hating their jobs and delivering shit to people they know who are rich, like, not one person is going to be, you know what, how about instead of delivering this fucking $3,000 coffee machine, I just go into their house, fuck up all of their beds and steal their jewelry? How about I just do that? I have the keys to their fucking house. That's what you're doing. You're giving the keys to your house to 300,000 people because it says Amazon on the fucking handle. Well done, everyone. All right, that's enough. That's about enough yelling, isn't it? Shall we get to these fucking, the worst part of the podcast, shall we? Yeah, let me have a sip of my chamomile and honey tea, which I knew I would need because I was like, oh, I'm talking about the belt today. I'm going to be fucking screaming for 15 minutes. I should preempt my own rage and get myself a nice little tea to calm my throat and soothe my feelies. Let me just do a sip. It's fucking cold. I spent too long yelling about the fucking belt. All right. So if you don't know, miscellaneous bit at the end is the last part of the podcast, the worst part of the podcast that everyone dreads. It provokes suicide, self-harm, and disbelief in one's own abilities. So please do turn off now if you have any self-esteem that you would like to retain. So, if you want to send it, basically, if you don't know, I answer life advice questions from people. I don't like talking about myself for an hour, so I like hearing a lot of gossip from people whose when their lives don't affect me, I can hear about all their fucked up problems. It's fascinating. So, if you have a question that needs answering, or if you have a funny story that you want to tell me, email podcast@lewspears.com. That is podcast@lewspears.com. All right? So, here's the first email. G'day, Lewis. In the 40th episode of your podcast, you talked about the joke you made about the Dreamworld ride accident. That's fine. I'm not going to scold you for that. I'm just wondering if now that you work on Triple M Modern Digital, will there be any consequences from you making jokes that could be considered controversial or in poor taste in the future? Just for some context, you also mentioned that you can't get fired over the jokes you make because you are your own boss. Unlike the Tasmanian radio host that made a joke the day after the accident happened, I heard about that. A Tasmanian radio host made a joke on air and got fired for it. And that's just fucking stupid. Like, of course he got fired for it. Yeah, that's actually a really good question, and it's something that I'm happy to address. Here's my idea on it, okay? The way I see it, right, I'm a comedian. I tell jokes. If I were to ever get in trouble for telling a joke, I would just respond with, it's a joke. I don't ever see myself apologizing for a joke. I don't see that ever happening in my life. I mean, let's say I told a joke and then someone took it seriously and punched somebody in the face. Fucking oath. I'd apologize for that. I'd be like, oh, actually, I probably wouldn't. Hey, I didn't punch anyone. I don't know. I try and think of scenarios. I would never say never. Actually, yeah, I would. I would never fucking apologize for a joke. If I know that it's a joke and I am confident that I conveyed it as a joke, then yeah, I would never apologize for a joke. But also, I'm not fucking stupid and I wouldn't make a joke about a fucking tragedy where 4 people died on radio. Of course I wouldn't do that. I'm not a fucking idiot. I would definitely save that shit for Twitter. And yeah, so basically what you were saying is, You're right. I can never get fired for telling a horrible joke when I am my own boss. But now that I'm in the radio, I'm not my own boss. I have a boss. We have people that we answer to. We have people that want us to do well. We have people that are banking on us making money for the station. Like, there are a lot of people around us that want to make money out of Luke and I's dumb fucking jokes. And yeah, if I told a joke and an advertiser didn't like it, or it caused it, caused an outrage, that could cost them money, and they could pressure me to apologize. But I would say, fuck off. End of the day, man, I'm a comedian, and everything that I do is jokes, and I think that that outrage stuff, the tide is turning. And to give you an example, I have a stand-up, like you said, I have a stand-up joke about the Dreamworld ride. I'm currently on radio now, and I was doing that joke in New Zealand. So nothing has changed. The way I see it, I am absolutely going to be PC and safe and advertiser friendly on the radio, because I find it fun, and that's also the only way you can be on the radio. I mean, obviously we're going to push the boundaries of what is acceptable on radio, but at the end of the day, you can't yell cunt and then say in the meeting, "Oh, I was just pushing the boundaries." Like, there's very strict rules about literally. Like, some of the rules are, you cannot say these words. You can say shit, and you can say, you can say dick, but you can't say cunt, you can't say fuck, and you can't get a 15-year-old on the airways and bully them. Like, there's a rule for that for some reason. I think Kyle and Jackie O did it to some poor 15-year-old rape victim. They got her on a lie detector test and asked her if she's had sex before. And then she said on live radio to her mum, who was in the room, "Yes, you know I have. I was raped. I told you about this." So now they're real strict with that kind of underage stuff, which is, you know, fucking fair enough if you ask me. But yeah, on radio, radio stuff, I'm going to be PC, and I'm going to be very family friendly. I'm not going to swear. And you know what? I'm fucking fine with that. I'm having a lot of fun, because if you know what I do, you know I have all these silly fucking little ideas that are, but I have silly dumb ideas that are not big enough for a video, and kind of too silly and too PC to put in my YouTube videos or inside Lure Review, or to make a sketch out of, because it doesn't really fit with my online image. But now I can bring all of those PC silly dumb ideas to the radio station, and we can just talk about it, and it's fucking awesome. But that being said, yes, definitely being PC on the radio, but my promise to you is I'm not going to change anywhere else. Because that's what I had a real big think about when we got offered this radio opportunity, when they wanted us to do a show, and when we got offered the meeting. I told myself, if they tell me to tone it down anywhere else, like outside of the radio, outside of where they are paying me and where they are my boss, if they try to boss me around outside of that scope where they do have a say because they are trying to make money out of me, and that's fair enough, I would tell them to fuck off, right? And that has not happened, and it really surprised me. I think they understand, man. I think these people are finally starting to fucking get it. The outrage machine does not work anymore, and in most cases, it fucking benefits you, as it gets people talking. So, basically what I'm saying is, no, I'm not changing. The only difference to my content is that there is now more of it. And the type of more content I've decided to do is PC, family-friendly, dumb stuff. But I think I can pretty much say that it doesn't really matter. Like, we don't need to swear to make a good radio show. We don't need to talk about fuck stuff. And I don't think we particularly want to. Like, I get all of that out on this podcast and on Lure Review and Bi-Monthly Bull and even more on stage. I don't have any more fucking filthy ideas. The only ideas that I have left are silly family PC ideas. So, to answer your question, I could get in trouble. But no, I wouldn't ever change it. Like, if someone was like, "Hey, we're offering you $1 million... to do a radio show, but you have to stop the online thing," I'd be like, no. Even though I started this radio thing, stand-up comedy is still my number one priority. End of the day, I love making videos. I love doing radio. I love doing this podcast. But all of that is to feed my number one passion of doing stand-up comedy, because doing all this stuff helps me sell more tickets, do more shows, do bigger venues, and helps me get closer to my goal of being an international stand-up comedian. So that's what I'm trying to do. I think radio is going to help me with that. And I'm not going to let radio affect all of my other things. I mean, it has, because it's a lot more work that we've been doing, and I have struggled putting out videos these past couple of weeks. Actually, I've been pretty good, really. I've been almost weekly on my YouTube channel, but now that we killed ourselves for this first month because we wanted to get extended to the end of the year, but now we've been extended to the end of the year, we can kind of relax on the radio thing, and instead of trying to really prove ourselves to the higher-ups, we can just kind of focus on making a really good radio show for the last 2 months of the year, and then also figure out how we can fit in the videos and the podcast and everything else that we're doing into the radio stuff. And yeah, I feel really good about that. So yeah, man, to answer your question, yes, I could get in trouble for it. But I don't think that's going to happen. Like I'm telling you, man, I am the most surprised person out of everyone who's involved with this, fans, Luke, everyone else. I'm so fucking surprised that the higher-ups here haven't said a single thing about what I do outside of the radio station, and I'm really, really happy with that. They're very supportive of the online thing, so I'm going to keep doing it. I'm going to keep saying fucked up stuff on videos and even worse stuff on stage and trying to make people laugh in the horrible ways that I do, and on the side, I'll be doing this radio thing. So, yeah, I hope that answers your question, man. All right, how much time do we have left here? Oh, we got a bit of time. All right, let's do another email. Oh, another sip of tea. All right. The subject line for this one is... to answer the last question, no, never apologizing for a joke. Don't think I'm going to get in trouble for anything. If I do, we'll fucking see what happens and I'll tackle it head on. You know what I'm like. Alright, the subject line for this new email is, friend is actively trying to cheat on her boyfriend. Ooh, this is fucking juicy. Hiya, I hope everything's going well with your tours and success shit. I'm trying, man, I don't think I'm exactly there yet. I mean, I'm 23 and I still live with my fucking mother, so trying to get there. Where are we? You can call me Noah. Because fuck it, even if my friends know who you were, they wouldn't listen to podcasts. They're a true podcast listener. They know that nobody fucking listens. I have a bit of a moral dilemma going on. Most of my friends are girls, so... that's a moral dilemma in itself, isn't it, man? Most of my friends are girls. So, 2 days ago, after a sports game at my school, we all went to a diner to eat. While we were there, a guy came in and one of my girlfriends adamantly started talking about how she was going to trick him into being friends so she could inevitably fuck him. The issue is, she has a boyfriend of about a year and a half, but she doesn't seem to care. Yuck. I've tried talking her out of even thinking about trying something, but she says that friends are supposed to be supportive. Oh my god. This is the kind of shit that you read and you have to remind yourself to have respect for women. And I know that's a horrible thing to say, but you know that the women listening to this podcast also heard that and were like, man, our whole gender is fucked. But, you know, ladies, what I'm saying is, I bet you've heard a fucking sentence that a football player has said, and you've been like, man, I wish I was a lesbian. Like, I wish I loved pussy. I just can't do it. Because men suck. She says that friends are supposed to be supportive. The other issue here is that it turns out the guy she's trying to bang is someone I've known for 5 years. The girl's name is Charlotte, also made a private Instagram where she's already blocked her boyfriend. Yeah, so she's planning to cheat. So your mate's with a whore. She's already blocked her boyfriend, so in the future she can talk about this situation to whoever she's allowing to follow her. I have a few possible solutions. Originally, I was just going to screenshot her talking about it and tell her boyfriend. But I realized if I do that, they'd probably break up and then she just gets to do what she wanted anyways. Well, yeah. What's wrong with that? And I feel like she just doesn't deserve that when she's being such a cunt about it. Well, I mean, it's not really your fucking decision what she deserves, is it? My other idea is that I could tell the guy I've known for 5 years and warn him not to do anything or even acknowledge it. Yeah, that's a good idea. How do you reckon that's going to go? Hey, Michael, you know my really hot friend? Yeah. Yeah, the one with the huge tits. Yeah. She wants to fuck you and be really secretive about it and cheat on her boyfriend. I'm just letting you know so that you don't do that, even though that you're single and you don't know her boyfriend and it'll probably never have any negative repercussions. Just letting you know to not... Yeah, dude, that's... What do you think's going to happen? He's going to be like, oh, sweet, free route. She's generally a good person. No, she's not. So this whole cheating thing is just out of the blue, and I don't know what to do here. Any ideas? Sorry about the wall of text. On the phone, so formatting is shit. Good luck on your journey to success. Looking forward to seeing you in America at some point. Have a shit one. Yeah, I'll make it to the US at some point, man. Okay, let me figure out your relationship with the girl's boyfriend. Do that. Blah, blah, blah. Yeah, look, man. Here's the thing. I would weigh up... Ah, fuck. You know what, man? All right, here's what you do. Do not get involved. Do not fucking get involved. It will ruin your life. Oh, Luke Kidgel's coming and he wants to help me, I think. Or he's just trying to... Are you coming to help me answer this question or distract me?
Distract you.
Okay. Are you finished with yours?
Yeah, I just wanted to come in and ruin yours because you ruined mine before.
Oh, yeah. Do you know why I'm doing it for longer even though I started before you?
Because you left to do a phone call?
No. I was pretending to be on the phone. That was actually... My podcast was recording the whole time. I needed to get my puffer.
From upstairs?
Yeah, it took
ages.
Did you
record the whole time?
Yeah, I was just pretending that I was on the phone. It worked a treat.
Did you no guys one talked to that?
Me. I hope not.
That's a one-way thing. I can't answer. I hated it.
Was that you pretending that it was a phone call? You really what? Have. Was that you pretending this is a phone call like I was?
No, I'm just blatantly coming in to ruin your podcast.
Yeah, you really have ruined this.
Have I done it?
No, the reason why...
I'm sure you were on a really good workflow and now I've just...
No, I'm just answering a question. I just said, oh, I wonder if Luke can help. Okay, so... a guy is mainly friends with girls.
Hey guys, in case you haven't heard enough of me recently with the radio show.
Oh yeah, fuck. This is the last question. We've got like 10 minutes. The reason why I'm still recording is because I yelled about fucking Amazon Key for 10 minutes and then realized I wasn't recording.
That's right.
I was fucked.
I yelled about My Little Pony for ages because I went to Google LP, then accidentally Googled MLP.
Ooh, that's a good
mistake. Yeah, because I was talking about the New Zealand drink, LP. Yeah. And then I just went on a massive rant about being a bro.
Anyway, the people have had enough of us, so let's get this fucking over quick. So, a guy's mostly friends with girls, and one of his girlfriends has a boyfriend and is openly talking about cheating on him with another guy. And he wants to know, should I tell the guy? She has a target picked out. She knows who she wants to cheat with. So this guy's like, should I tell the boyfriend or... should I tell the guy that she wants to cheat with not to do it? And I was like, you can't tell the guy not to do it because he's single. Like, all you're going to do is be like, hey, you know my real hot friend with the huge
rack?
What
about you tell the girl to not be a fucking bitch?
He has. And she said, here's the sentence where I said, this is a sentence that makes you question whether you should respect women or not, all right? She said, friends are supposed to be supportive.
Oh, right, and girlfriends are supposed to not cheat on their boyfriends, you piece of shit.
Yeah, but if you're friends, you should just be like, yeah, go, cheat on your fucking man. Anyway.
Who's that supporting?
So this is my theory.
That's like supporting a sex fest. It's like, yeah, go, do it, Rolf. I don't care. You know what I mean? Like, that's...
High five.
Yeah.
So here's my theory. I think that the guy should anonymously tell the boyfriend. He's got screenshots, right? He should anonymously send the screenshots to the boyfriend on Facebook with a fake account, leave no trace back to you, and act really surprised when the girl tells you about it. Because you don't want to get personally involved, because it'll just ruin your life.
That's really good advice.
Yeah, I've done it before.
Really?
Yeah,
worked this exact situation.
No, I found out about someone cheating on another person, and I wasn't close enough with either of them to say it, so I just made a fake account and sent the screenshots. Oh yeah, it was, dude, I got to watch the whole fallout on Twitter. It was fucking awesome. I felt like God. I got to watch the girl.
Like you were playing Sims.
Oh, it was the best shit ever. I got to watch the girl being like, fucking dog cunts, can't trust anyone. And I got to watch the guy being like, man, there are some angels out there. And I'm like, dude, I'm God and the devil right now in this moment. And it was fucking good. And that's what I suggest this guy do. Anonymously send proof to the other guy.
Yeah, do it.
And that's your solution, man.
I mean, it'll definitely break up their relationship and you will be responsible. Not really. She's responsible for it. You're not doing anything wrong.
Nah, you're
doing the right thing, actually. The dude...
Because that's how I would want to know.
The boyfriend deserves to know.
Yeah, and that's how I would... When I think about it, if I was ever being cheated on, that would be the ideal way that I find out, is just some anonymous fucking stranger sends me screenshots. I'm like, cool. Now I can just send them to her and get rid of her. Right?
No, but if the screenshots are from their conversation, it can be traced back to him.
No, he has, like, screenshots of her setting up a private Instagram account where she's blocked her boyfriend so she can cheat on him and he won't find
disgusting.
Out.
That's disgusting.
Yeah, she's, like, really pre-planning this shit. It's real gross.
So she's like a method whore. Like, she's got, like... Yeah. She's got a full, like...
She's figured it out.
24-point plan of how to be a fucking whore.
This is so different to our radio show. Yeah.
It's so weird. We're in the radio studios slut shaming.
Yeah, on a phone instead of on million
dollar
mics.
So should we dump that last 10 minutes or the last hour?
Yeah, Michael,
of this
can you play a sound effect? Oh, that's right.
Here.
No one's paying him, so he's not fucking here. Yeah. All right, guys, that's the end of the podcast. Thank you very much for listening. Thanks.
I actually didn't even ruin that.
No, you actually kind of improved it.
Fuck,
yeah.
Hang on, can I come back and ruin it?
Yeah, hang on. I'll do the wrap up, then you come in. If you like my stuff, make sure to support me on Patreon. You get access to the podcast early and everything like that.
Hey, Lewis, you doing a podcast?
Yeah, I am.
All right,
man.
Sucks.
All right, thank you. You just ruined it.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, also, buy tickets to my comedy special. There are like 30 left to each night, so they're going to sell out really quick, and all of the seats are good. On the seating charts, they look shit, but trust me, I've been there. Every fucking seat in there is a banger. We actually had to remove the shitty seats because that's where we put the cameras, so, yeah.
And also, Lewis won't tell you this. He did the show in all throughout New Zealand, and it is fucking bang on. Ask anyone who went to those shows. I mean, I went to all of them, and that was the exact show that he'll be doing in the special. And if you can't get tickets because you live overseas or in state, you can still pre-order that shit, right?
Yeah, if you can get on Indiegogo.
Do it. It's like $5, and it'll honestly be the best $5 you've ever spent.
Oh, look at him. How nice is he to me? Yeah,
Also, your podcast sucks dick. Dab. All right, I'm out.
That's the end. All right, guys. Have a shit one. I'll talk to you on Sunday.